Thank you very much, Carol. Thank you, Amanda, and congratulations to the Pacific Library Partnership Staff Development Committee. I always say that this is one of the best days of the year because we really do showcase the great talent. As I look in the room, there's a lot of rock stars in the audience, a lot of people that do great work on behalf of all of our libraries in the peninsula, the Bay Area. So congratulations, and I know you're going to have a fantastic day. I did want to take a moment to say that we're very proud to be in San Francisco. Every day is a good day to be in San Francisco, but today is particularly good because it's Farmers Market Day. So there's a great Farmers Market that I hope you take advantage of the great eats there. We also have a fabulous Summer of Love 50th anniversary exhibit right around the corner here in the gallery, so please avail yourselves for that. I do want to offer a couple of remarks because I think that future readiness is so important. I mean, I've always been a strong advocate of having libraries be responsive to our community, making sure that we always push the envelope in making sure that we build our communities and strengthen them. And in looking at the amazing array of programs today, what I notice is that you really are looking at whether it's teen services or new outreach models, ways of civic engagement and partnerships. That's really what it's about. And here at the San Francisco Public Library over the last year and a half, we convened a group of thought leaders and influencers that we call the Future of the Library Forum. And the whole idea was that we really look at how do we position our libraries, how do we take the best of what's happening throughout our country and beyond, and really make our library the best it can possibly be, similar to what all of you are doing in your respective libraries. And there's four themes that I want to just share briefly because it's a work in progress, like the future is always about a work in progress, right? But the first area focuses on kind of impact and the theory of change. So we've got a whole group convened on really looking at early literacy and some of the programs on that front and talk about what difference will we make if we really look at change and responding to our community. So that's one group that's doing fabulous work. It's challenging, it's difficult, but great talent to push that envelope. The second area we're calling optimizing public service. And it's really a euphemism for saying, let's really look at the work we're doing. Look at what does the future of work look like for us? Because it's changing, right? Whether we're librarians, whether we're paraprofessionals, any job description, you need to look at it, look at revising it, look at tweaking that, and it's difficult in our environment, in our industry. So optimizing public service really means that we have to focus on looking at traditional classification and job description and really define the work that we do on behalf of our community. The third area is all about user experience. How many of you heard that term now, user experience? It's all about the lens of the user, not what we think they should be doing and learning, but really learning from them. And that's been kind of a game changer, and it will be for us in terms of looking at our reference models, looking at the various service that we deliver. So user experience, keep that in mind in all the work that you do. It's about them, not about us. And it's difficult because we're great in terms of the staff and the talent that we have, but we learn so much from our users. And then the last one, which is an entire team working on what we're calling a learning organization. Think about that. We are, in fact, always learning. The reason that you invest an entire day today is because you want to learn. You want to really focus on new skills, engaging staff. And one of the things that I've learned in my four decades of doing this is that it's not a top-down proposition, it's a bottom-up. It's staff that does the work on behalf of community that we can learn from. So I hope that you keep that in mind, and when we talk about learning organizations, libraries are always adapting. And so when we look at the future, that's what it's gonna be all about how we are so organic and being able to change to really reflect our communities and never to forget that there's an equity proposition that we serve all of our communities equitably and keep in mind that value of social justice as well. So with that, I just want to welcome all of you and have a fabulous day. If there's anything we can do to make your stay enjoyable, please call on us. Thank you.